You know, some time ago, I got this article from a reliable source. Now, and it asks a specific question. Are psychiatrists terrorists? Now, this article that I read came from Freedom Magazine, which is owned by Scientology. I'm not an anti-Scientologist, critic, nor a member of the anonymous group that's been known to attack Scientology, non-violently, of course. But I tend to be like an outsider looking in, inside the box, of course. From what I've seen from both Scientology and Anonymous, I tend to agree with Anonymous sometimes, because the sources that they gave me, the information they give me, are more like questions, and I find an answer. Now, they mentioned that Aghzawi, or the second in command of Al-Qaeda, is a psychiatrist. Now, of course, I went to Wikipedia, and they said he's a surgeon. Now, so who's telling the truth? Scientology or Anonymous? Now, I do not agree with neither side, nor do I want to take sides, but I do want to say who's telling the truth, in my opinion. It seems that Anonymous seems to back up more of their claims than Scientology can. Now, Scientology has always been controversial because of its views on psychiatry and mental issues. Now, for me to be slightly mentally defective, I tend to agree that psychiatrists are not terrorists, but a few of them could cause harm to their clients if they, disobey the rules that are set within the state or federal levels. Now, some time ago, I think it was late last year, a psychiatrist committed suicide. Why did he commit suicide? Because he was going to be found guilty of sexual assault, or some kind of sex crime. I can't remember what it was, but it was he committed a sexual crime, and he was going to be punished, and he will probably get his license revoked. So that tells me that psychiatrists are kind of like the people who need to be somewhat looked at a little bit closer, even though we should not look at all the psychiatrists, but those who are causing the most complaints filed against them. Now, sometimes Scientology tends to yet really back up what they say, but they can't really do it because everything is so hush hush with them, you can't get a straight answer. I mean, they always said confront your critics, but yet when a member Anonymous comes up to them, they seem to ignore them. Why? I don't know. Maybe because they are afraid of Anonymous, because they see the truth, and they know the truth. Now, I've never been one to pick sides in this type of issue, but if I had to choose sides, I would choose Anonymous, because they seem to back up more claims than Scientology can. Now, I don't want to be an anti-Scientology, critic, but this is just my view on this issue. Now, I had issues with them, saying that there's no such thing as autism, and yet I constantly speak about autism on my video, on my rants. But yet, earlier this year, Jet DeVolta died, and he was autistic. Not many people knew about this until we heard about it through, Entertainment Tonight, The Doctors, any celebrity show, we heard about it. Now, why would DeVolta's hide the secret of their son being autistic? Are they afraid of autism? Are all Scientology afraid of a disorder that exists? This is more of an open challenge to Scientology, for a debate. Now, I know there may be some anti saying, "Oh, you're a member of the industry of death." Listen, I'm a free thinker, and free thinkers tend to think outside of the box rather than inside of the box. So before any Scientologists judge me, I just want them to ask this question. Why would someone deny a mental crisis that exists today? If we do not confront them about these type of issues, then they don't deserve to be called a church. They deserve to be called a business or a cult. It seems that businesses or cults tend to deny more things than a religion. Now, in Germany, Scientology is a business. In some other countries as well, and most of them banned it because most people banned Scientology because of its cult-like reputation. Now, of course, there may, like, now back on, now, their views on psychiatry is a little barbaric and immature to judge. I mean, I do not judge a lot of people. I believe it's bad luck to judge people. But I will say this about some people who think that people should be treated like animals or anything else. Yes, psychiatry has been barbaric in the past, and yet we decided to evolve it from what it was to what it is today. Now, true, Scientology may have its views on, you know, the Holocaust, psychiatry, autism, or other mental issues. Now, I'm gonna put the link that where I got this from, and I also like to thank Crazy Delaney, which I believe I got this from. Crazy Delaney, thank you for making this aware of my thank you for making me aware of their barbaric views on psychiatry, because I had to go through psychiatrists a lot through my life, and yet they have helped me become the person I'm today. Yes, I have not been to one in a very long time, but yet I realize that psychiatry does help if you get the right person who is willing to help you in a good, sensible way. And not all psychiatrists are bad. So I just want you guys to think about this. If we could just judge one psychiatrist, I mean, that's like judging an entire entire plantation of trees because of one bad apple. True, I may not make any sense, but at least I'm trying to get my point of view across this issue. And I hope to hear some good comments and replies. And hopefully some negative ones as well. But that's what I expect when I rant about this type of stuff.